was ringing up like a real high brass or something. I thought it was a plate, but unfortunately not. But we'll take that. First decent one of the day. Okay, I think I got another bullet here, but I'm 100% sure. Ringing a little high for a bullet. Let's see. It's a bullet, all right. Casing. It's like 30.
Another dropped Gardner. Gardner's Confederate.
I believe we have another dropped Gardner's here. I can see it. If you can see it.
When you're on a river, whether you're hunting or relic hunting or fishing or just enjoying the day, you never know what you're gonna run into. And you sometimes run into some nasty things like that. Let's see if I can. Okay. Groundhog, and he is right. I can't get any closer. Ugh. Loaded up. One time my dad, he told me a story.
He was, that's enough, right? He was inner tubing down the South River and came around a bend feet first, and right ahead of him was a dead goat floating in the water like that, except, you know, 3 or 4 times as big. And he hit it with his feet, and when he did, it burst, and all the putrid insides just sprayed out all over him. So that's a wonderful experience. But anyway, I don't think he's going to make it. Well, I've got a what I think is a coin over here. Matter of fact, when the signal picked up the signal on the AT Pro, it was ringing 84, 85. I mean, just solid and sweet tone, no scratches to it. And I thought to myself, that sounds like a coin. And I think it is. So we're gonna go underwater and see what we got. In the waterproof case we go.
Wait to get home and clean it up. Looks like it could be a large cent. It's not the right size for a modern quarter, so it's, I believe it's a copper. So it may be too corroded to figure it out, but we'll take it home and see what we can pull out of it. Okay, I think we have another bullet here. Sure does sound like one. So let's go see. Caliber. That's a nice one.
Game of time.